Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hello children, hope everybody is safe at home. Today we are going to learn the next lesson, lesson 5, uses of plants. Let's get started children. What do you observe in the picture children? Birds are sitting on a tree. So tree is their home. What is this? Fruits and vegetables. Can you think just for a minute? From where do we get these? Yes, we get them from plants. What is the next one? Wooden table and chair. Even wood, from where do we get children? We get this also from the plants. Wow, almonds, walnuts, cashew nuts, all are very tasty. At the same time, they are good for our health. Even the nuts we get from the plants. Oil. Oil we use for cooking. Have you tasted puris? Yes. How mummy is able to fry the puris? Using the cooking oil. So, all these things we get from plants. So, today we are going to learn about the uses of plants. Children, we know that plants are very important for life to sustain on earth. During photosynthesis, plants release oxygen. Oxygen is essential for the survival of living beings. At the same way, plants also take in carbon dioxide from the environment and purify the air. So children, that's why we have to grow more plants. What do you observe in the slide, children? It's raining and the weather is so cool. Yes, now we will see how plants help us in getting rain. Through the process of transpiration, plants release water vapor. Children, already in the last lesson, we have learned what is transpiration. What is transpiration? Loss of water in the form of water vapor from the leaves is called as transpiration. So, what happens to the water vapor released by the plants? This water vapor released into the atmosphere form clouds. These clouds come down as rain when condensation happens. So, that's why we say we have to grow more trees. Isn't it, children? Next comes how plants prevent soil erosion by holding the topsoil together. You can see in the picture how the roots are holding the soil. So, roots of plants hold the soil and prevent soil erosion. What do you observe in the picture, children? Plants provide shelter. Plants provide shade to living beings. They are also homes to many animals, birds, and insects. Plants provide us food and also many useful things such as wood, paper, fiber, medicine, rubber, and so on for people to lead a comfortable life. So, in this lesson, we will learn about how plants are giving us food, how we use plants as food, and how they provide us with various products. Come children, let's learn how plants provide various food materials such as cereals, pulses, fruits and vegetables, spices, nuts, oil, and beverages. Children, now we will see about cereals. What are cereals? Have you ever tasted a chapati made by your mom? How she is able to make that? With a wheat flour. Yes. Even same way, dosa and idli. How do they make that? With a rice flour. Okay. So, what are cereals? Cereals are the seeds of plants. They are also called grains. They are rich in Carbohydrates. What are carbohydrates, children? Carbohydrates are the main sources of energy in our body. They keep our body warm and give us energy to do various activities in our everyday routine like playing, walking and studying. Okay, children. Now, food grains such as wheat, rice, barley, oats, bajra and maize are cereals. Next comes the pulses. What are pulses? Pulses are the dried seeds of certain plants. They are rich in proteins, minerals, and vitamins. What are proteins? Proteins are the main source of bodybuilding foods. Okay, small children like you need more protein. Why? Because you keep growing, no, children? So you have to include more of protein in your diets. Examples are red gram, green gram, black gram, peas, rajma, and soya beans. Next comes the fruits. Yes, everybody likes fruits, isn't it, children? Fruits such as apples, bananas, peaches, cherries, grapes, mangoes, melons, and oranges are rich in vitamins. Even we can make juice and jams from fruits. Yes, children, we enjoy mango milkshake during the summer season regularly. Yes, no? Now, we'll talk about vegetables, children. We eat many vegetables such as cabbage, cauliflower, spinach, potato. Yes, vegetables are sources of vitamins and roughage. Vegetables are even called as protective food, children, because they protect us from falling ill. Okay, so what is roughage now? Roughage is a fibrous material present in fruits and vegetables. Okay. Next comes the interesting part, spices. Have you ever tasted a hot biryani, children? Yes, it will be very tasty and spicy. Okay, how do we get that taste? From where do we get that taste? From the spices. So what are spices? Spices are used to add flavor and taste to the food. From where do we get them? They are obtained from various parts of some plants like flowers, seeds, fruits, bark and roots. Some examples of spices are cardamom. What do you mean by cardamom? Ilachi, children. Turmeric, black pepper and red chili. Can you observe the long sticks there, children? Cinnamon, it is called the cinnamon and is an example of bark taken out of a tree. Cloves, cloves is nothing but a flower bud which you see in the picture. Next comes the nuts. Nuts like groundnuts, cashew nuts, almonds and walnuts are obtained from plants. They are sources of proteins, vitamins and fats. They are very good for our health, children. So hereafter, make it a point that you daily include all this in your diet. Children, do you like chips, puri and vada? Yes, we all love to eat them. Yes or no? Yes. All these items are fried in oil. Then from where do we get that oil? Oil is extracted from the seeds of plants. Some plants yield edible oil which we use for cooking. Examples are seeds of plants such as mustard, olive, sunflower, groundnut and coconut. Then comes the beverages. What is a beverage, children? A drink other than water is called a beverage. Tea and coffee are obtained from plants. Now we'll see how we get coffee. We get coffee from coffee beans. Coffee beans are extracted from the coffee plants. These beans are first dried, crushed to make coffee powder, which is used to make coffee at home. What do you observe in this slide, children? They are cutting the tea leaves. Yes. Now we are going to talk about tea. Tea is obtained from the tea leaves. The leaves of tea plants are dried, crushed, fermented, and dried again to prepare tea. What do you observe in the picture, children? We see the chocolate. From where do we get chocolates, children? Cocoa beans are used to prepare cocoa powder and chocolates. Next comes the sugar. From where do we get sugar, children? Sugar is obtained from the juice of the sugarcane plant. So, children, we learned about how plants are the most important source of food for human beings. They provide us various food materials such as cereals, pulses, fruits, vegetables, spices, oil, and beverages. So, here is a simple assignment for you to do to check whether you have understood the concepts. Shall we go into the assignment? Sanjay observed some plants and classified them as in the table below. There are two columns, children, X and Y. Under X column, wheat, rice and barley are there. Under Y column, beans, peas and rajma are there. Now, what is the activity for you? Guess the column headings, X and Y. Then, Sanjay wants to include Bajira in the second column. Will that be correct? Give reason for your answer. With this assignment, we end up this module. Thank you, children.